Hi viewers, this is Sri Ramulu. So today's topic is crystallography by powder method. So crystallography by powder method. What is the meaning of crystallography by powder method? So let me explain. The Bragg spectrometer can be used to diffract X-rays by a single crystal free from distortion. Distortion means free from defects. So which cannot have any defects means inside this crystal atoms are arranged in a regular manner and no other atoms present inside in between the or some other atom cannot be present here. So such a crystal is called free from distortion. There are a variety of materials in the nature. There are the variety of materials are there. So among them, metals, alloys and powder. Alloy means it is a mixture. Powder means a small sized solid substance. Actually, only a few substances which are available in the form of large single crystal. Okay, so there are only a few substances are there which can available in the large single crystal. So they contain the large quantities, mean small crystals, one crystal. Powder crystal method is a standard technique to study the structure of microcrystal. See, this is a powder crystal method is a very much easy method to understand, to know the nature and structure of the microcrystal. Microcrystal means a crystal which is converted into small powders. Each powder point inside the powders is a microcrystal. Small size crystal is called microcrystal. Here large number they contains and they are single crystal. This single crystal is microcrystal here. The experimental arrangement of powder method is shown in figure. See the figure. So this is a powder method crystal. Okay. X-rays from X-ray tube. So generally X-rays where they are generated from the X-ray tubes are allowed to pass through a filter F which absorbs all the wavelength except one. See the diagram here, filter F. See here it is a filter. From this side many X-rays are coming, but with a different wavelength they come. Okay, then what we have to do, we have to filter them different wavelengths and allow the single wavelength. That wavelength is called monochromatic wavelength of X-rays. Single wavelength X-ray we have to allow by keeping a filter F in the path of X-ray. The beam is collimated by passing it through two fine slits S1 and S2 cut into two lead plates. Here a beam of X-ray is collimated means sent by passing them through two fine means small slits present S1 and S2. Okay, so cuts into lead plates. So generally these two slits are prepared with the lead plates. Lead is a device substance. It is one lead plate, it is another lead plates, and it is they cut in middle and it can act as a slit. So like this two slits are arranged here in the path of X-ray. This fine pencil of X-ray is made to fall on the powdered specimen C. See, powder specimen C. It is a substance in which a powdered crystal contains. Okay, so inside it a powder crystal contains. Then X-rays are coming like this and they are filtered here and coming through slit S1, S2 and falling on the specimen which contain powdered form of crystals. The specimen is located at the center of drum shaped cassette with the photographic plate at the inner circumference. Okay, specimen is located at the center. At the center means it is what it is, a photographic plate, and so how the cassette in, so you have seen the in the past last in past years. So cassette, nowadays we have the mobile phones to listen the songs, but in olden days a cassette project, and cassette contains a reel, okay, that is called a film having small thickness only. Such a reel is surrounded in this manner, okay, not completely, up to here only, and it may have the center, and where the center present, there only specimen is kept, okay. See, for this, where the center present, there only specimen is kept. That is okay, a drum shaped with a cassette photographic plane at the inner circumference. Okay friends, sorry for the disturbance. And next, the basic principle, is it okay? The basic principle of this powder technique is that in the powder, millions of microcrystals have all the possible random orientation, means direction. So powder form of crystal means lead is a very small crystal, and it may orient in this direction, another crystal may orient like this, and some crystal may orient in this direction, and some crystal oriented in this direction, means all the possible, how many directions present, in all the possible directions they may be oriented, means their direction may be present like this. Among these all the things, very large number of microcrystals, okay, large number of microcrystals present, and there will always exist some crystal whose lattice planes are so oriented to satisfy the Bragg's relation. Okay, among the large crystals, a few crystals, what happened? They may oriented in such a direction to obey the Bragg's law. Okay, suppose like this they are oriented. So like this, if they oriented in this manner, they may obey the Bragg's law. If they oriented like this, they may obey Bragg's law. If they oriented like this, they also obey Bragg's law. So equally plane, the planes of those crystals must be in the same direction, and a gap between the crystal planes must be same. Okay. Planes oriented to satisfy the Bragg's relation, n lambda is equals to 2d sin theta, or 2d sin theta is equals to n lambda. So this is Bragg's equation. Okay. So only a certain crystals may be oriented to satisfy this Bragg's law. Then what we can get by using this relation, we can calculate theta value. Okay. For calculating theta value only, this powder wet technique is used. Reflection takes place at these planes for a value of theta. The beam appears at the corresponding to 2 theta deviation. Okay, here it is a 2 theta is taken, 2 theta deviation. So what happens while deriving this equation, there I explained, when x-rays are coming like this and they strike to the atom, they reflect in this direction. One other x-rays comes like this and it may strike to the atom and reflects in this direction. Only reflection will occur. Okay. And because of this reflection, what happens? Small dots will appear on the screen. So why? Because light cannot reach us. So where they cannot reach us, their dots are present. Okay, dots like this. In this manner dots. So those dots can be studied. And next, as the parallel lattice planes with a given spacing d and the same value of n theta occurs in all positions around the axis of incident beam. Here the parallel lattice planes, so like this, these are the parallel lattice planes. Lattice planes means the planes which are passing through the lattice points, those are called lattice planes, and the gap or spacing between the any two lattice plane is same, that is a d. So d like this we calculate by taking the values of theta and n value. N is order, theta is angle. So this angle, the reflected rays produce a cone with a semi vertical angle to theta. So here what happens, why they produce a cone? Here it is a cassette, or it is a photographic plate is kept in this manner, and X-rays are coming like this, and they are falling on the specimen which contains the powder. Then they starts diffracting. A few rays may go like, X-rays may go like this and like this or like this. Okay. So then this is the angle, and see, by this see, it is forming one cone and it can form another cone, right? So like this cones are formed. With the cones means at the end of the cone circle will form. So see, the diagram is this. The reflector rays produce a cone with a semi vertical angle t 2 theta. See, this angle is 2 theta, and the set for various set of d and n. So for different set of d and n values, and various cones of rays are obtained. One such a cone is shown here. Okay, such a cone is shown here. Next, the scattered X-rays are incident on the photographic film. Scattered X-rays incident on photographic film. The intersection of the different cones of the photographic film are series of concentric circular rings. Yes, concentric circular rings. Suppose it is a specimen. X-rays are coming like this, and it is a screen. What happens? This ray X-ray may diffract like this. This may diffract like this. And see, at this point they may form a circular ring. And another X-ray also by the another planes. What happens? They also diffract and they may form one more like this. So like this, many circular rings with the concentric means their center must be same. Okay, its center is here only. So that is why they are called concentric rings. Now the interplanar distance of crystals, crystalline substance can be calculated. Okay, so interplanar distance, how can we calculate? See here, the pattern recorded on the photographic film is shown in figure. So this is a figure. This pattern is recorded. Due to a narrow width of the film, only parts of circular rings are registered on it. Means, if this film is like this, very much large, then what happens? This can completely appears like this, and the next ring can appears like this completely. But because of it is a small width, so only part, so this part is appearing. The curvature of arcs reverses when the angle of diffraction exceeds 90. Okay, see here, it is a specimen containing the powder, and here it is screen means photographic plate. Okay, so like this, when they are falling like this, then they form like these circles they forms. Okay, why? Because it is angle is this much. But if they are scattered like this with a 90 degree, then instead of forming circle, instead of forming this arc, they make reverse like this. So that is why these reverse arcs are formed. Okay, because of 90 degree between incident ray and reflected ray. Okay. Let L1, L2 and L3 etc. Be the distances between the symmetrical line on stretched photograph, and D is the diameter of cylindrical film. So its diameter is what? How much? It is capital D. And L1, L2 are the, these are also nothing but diameters or distances from where to where. It is L1, for this L2, and for this L3. So like this. Then see the equations to calculate theta. So length by pi D is equals to 4 theta 1 by 360 degrees. So then from this equation we can write theta 1 is equals to 4 1 ja, 4 9 ja, 90 ja, 360. So theta 1 is equal to 90 by pi d L1. So if you know the L1 value by using this diagram, then you can easily calculate theta. So by substituting theta value in the 2D sin theta is equals to n lambda, then you can easily calculate spacing or this distance between the interplane. So in distance between the plane, we can easily calculate by using this equation. So like this, theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 are there. So we can calculate for this and this, for this, for this. So how much they have the distances. Okay, friends.